Welcome to the demonstration of 32Soft's Work Order Production Planner Data Loader. This tool has been designed to allow efficient maintenance of production plans in QAD using discrete work orders. Work Order Production Planner provides real-time access to QAD data and instant visibility of ordered quantities, available resources, and planned demands, all in easy-to-use Excel spreadsheets. We're going to take a look at how to use Work Order Production Planner to manage production plans with greater efficiency and greater accuracy. With this data loader tool, we can create production plans in QAD using a set of discrete work orders, approve MRP planned orders, modify or split existing work orders, change work order status or due date, and release it. We can also check components availability for our production plan. Work Order Production Planner will simulate allocation of the components from stock towards the production plan and reveal material shortages on all levels of bill of materials. This allows for management of material supplies in a timely manner, identification of potential production issues, and prioritization of work orders. Additionally, we can view production plans from the capacity availability perspective, analyze projected capacity shortages, and either adjust the production plan or make changes to the available capacity by increasing it during production peak times. Built-in what-if analysis functionality in Work Order Production Planner allows us to simulate changes to production plans and check capacity and inventory impact without even modifying the production plan in QAD. Managing work orders in QAD using 32Soft's Work Order Production Planner requires zero additional system resources. Let's take a look. Once we open Work Order Production Planner, we must select the correct database first. We click the Setup button to find our database and select it. In the header, we specify our selection criteria, including site, range of due dates, and types of work orders. We then click on the Download button to download open work orders from QAD into an Excel spreadsheet. As soon as we select any of the action buttons for the first time, a login screen appears. As this is our first time connecting to QAD since opening Production Planner, we are asked to specify QAD user ID, password, and domain. So let's log in. As with all 32Soft data loaders, Production Planner authentication is based on native QAD authentication logic that includes user ID, password, and menu and site security. If user authentication is successful, open orders that match selection criteria specified in the header will be downloaded into Excel. Downloaded orders will be automatically assigned a sequence or priority that later will be used for shortage and capacity calculations. Sequence is assigned based on the order status and due date. Orders with status R, meaning released, are assigned the highest priority, followed by firm, then exploded, allocated, and then planned orders. If we want to limit downloaded orders to final assembly items, we can set the final assembly flag to yes. Production Planner considers an item a final assembly if it is not used as a component in any bill of materials. Having the list of downloaded work orders, which is our production plan, we can check availability of the components for these work orders. To identify component requirements, Work Order Production Planner will first roll down work orders to the components level, identify components that have been already released into production, and calculate required dates and quantities for each component. Then it will take available and projected quantities on hand, order sequence and cumulative lead time, and simulate allocation of the components, revealing projected shortages. Optionally, we can include or exclude sub-assembly components by changing the field Only P for purchase components in the header. As a result of this calculation, work order status and the comment column will be updated, with status being assigned a value OK, planned, or short, where OK indicates components required by work order are available, planned means components are very likely to be available because either purchase order or released subassembly orders exist. And short status indicates that work order is short at least one of the components. A detailed report for work order components will be displayed on a separate tab, as we see down here. List and order of the fields on this tab will depend on whether the report has been generated by component, click on Shortages by Component button, or by Work Order, click on Shortages by Work Order button. On both Component Availability tabs, there will be detailed information about component, component required date, work order that requires this component, quantity required, quantity available for the work order, current quantity on hand, and order quantity. In addition to checking stock availability for existing work orders, Work Order Production Planner also allows us to verify stock availability for new or simulation work orders. To add a simulation work order to a what-if scenario, we need to just specify due date, item number, quantity, and, optionally, sequence. Let's go ahead and add an item. And if we leave sequence blank, simulation work orders will be assigned, by default, the lowest priority, and will have available inventory allocated to them only after allocating released, firm, exploded, allocated, and planned work orders, regardless of the due date for the simulation order. For this example, we'll assign sequence 1, and we'll run a shortage check. And as we see, we do not have enough components in our test environment to produce 100 of these, our added item. So let's try changing our quantity to 10. And we'll run simulation again. And now it looks like we have enough components for 10 of item 88-100. As part of the simulation scenario, we can modify work order due dates, sequences, and quantities. We can also put selected work orders on hold. Placing work orders on hold through Work Order Production Planner does not affect standard QAD functionality, but it does prevent those work orders from being taken into account by components and capacity availability calculations performed within Work Order Production Planner. To put a work order on hold, simply enter yes in the On Hold field and click on the Update On Hold button. And to release it, we update the status, just delete yes, and again, click the Update Hold button. Similar to Components Availability Check, we can analyze a set of downloaded work orders, or our production plan, from the Capacity Availability perspective. To do so, we need to click on Capacity Report. Work Order Production Planner will update the Capacity Status column and produce, on a separate tab down here, a detailed Work Center Utilization Report. Having a summary for the planned quantities, components, and capacity availability will help us efficiently manage work orders in QAD. Detailed Work Center Utilization Report, displayed on a separate tab, will show how resources are being consumed and at what point we start having capacity shortages. In this report, Work Center load for each item and operation is calculated based on standard item routing. The start for each operation is calculated forward from schedule date, taking into account operation move, wait, subcontract, run, setup, and queue times, and required overlap quantity. Available Work Center capacity is identified for each operation's start date based on the shop floor calendar and number of machines per work center. Work center capacity is consumed by operations based on start date and item sequence, with the entire load for an operation being assigned to its scheduled start date. All operations with a start date in the past are automatically scheduled for the current date. Work center load for each operation is subtracted from available capacity, and the result appears as the remaining capacity for the next operation. Capacity shortages are shown in red as negative remaining capacity. Based on the projected capacity availability and suggested quantity to reschedule, we can adjust our work orders. Production Planner also allows us to simulate production plan roll forward based on the available capacity. Let's go ahead and save our capacity tab under a different name so that we can compare it with a roll forward version. Okay, to simulate a roll forward of the ordered quantities, we need to set the order roll forward flag in the header to yes. By clicking again on the capacity report button, we get an updated work center utilization report, but this time, Work Order Production Planner will show suggested order quantities and their due dates based on the available capacity. We can see that we have no shortages, and the tool tries to consume available capacity available for each day. If we now compare capacity reports generated with and without order roll forwarding, we see how proposed order quantities and due dates have changed. This happens in simulation mode only and does not affect our QAD data. We can modify order quantities and due dates on the Order List tab and run multiple what-if scenarios for components and capacity availability before making a decision about whether to update our production plan in QAD. When ready, we can approve planned orders, modify or release existing work orders, or create new orders in QAD directly from Work Order Production Planner. We can do so from either the Orders List tab or from the Components Availability tab, where we can aggregate, if necessary, required subassembly quantities into one work order. To create new work orders from the main Orders List tab, we need to specify due date, item number, and quantity, and set approval flag to yes. We can approve or create as many as we want, and then we click on the Approve Work Order button. New work orders will be created in QAD with status Firm, as we see here. We can release it right away by clicking the Release Print button, or leave it as Firm and release it later. As with all 32 soft data loaders, before uploading any data, Work Order Production Planner performs data validation against QAD and will return an error message if inaccurate data is submitted. Any cell containing an error would be highlighted in red and include the reason for the error. Data is uploaded into QAD only when there are no errors. As demonstrated, 32Soft's Work Order Production Planner is a great productivity tool that is very easy to use, requires minimum training, and will significantly increase efficiency and accuracy of your production planning process. For more information about this and other productivity tools, or to start your free 60-day trial, email us at contact@32soft.com. And please be sure to visit our website to sign up for our free educational webinars. www.32soft.com. Thank you for your interest in our productivity tools and for taking the time to view this demonstration.